I was born in a land to the west, Volgan, famous for its merchants. There were great, bustling cities. But for me, they were suffocating. And so I set out in search of stones in faraway lands. There are dangers, for certain, but I much prefer to live this way. But for the life of me, I can't remember how I ended up here. It's as if I were drawn to the place, or lured in. Oh, I don't know. You know how they call this place Drang Lake, right? Well, in the old lore, in stories and the like, they said it had another name. What was it? Well, I don't know. It's just something I heard. Since long, long ago, many kingdoms have risen and fallen on this very spot. Each like a great flame that turns to soot. Maybe that's why people don't remember much about the past. You see that blacksmith over there? Is he one of those hollows? He seems to keep eyeing me up. He sort of looks like my father. He's a blacksmith too, you see. The poor man's such a worrywart. But he wouldn't follow me out here, would he?
My witless daughter finally came home. Just as oblivious as she's always been. Well, at least now I can keep an eye on her. Stones? Try asking my daughter. You might be surprised.
These stones may look all the same, but to the trained eye, each is unique. Some of them are used to smith weapons and armor, and some unique stones provide special benefits. Some of them are extremely rare and should be used with great thrift. None of the differences are easily spotted, but I've learned quite a lot, really.
Gavlan know you. What you want? Many deal, many thanks.
Thank you. Still on the road, are you? Sorry to have burdened you so. This is for you, by way of an apology. I found my thoughts growing hazy. My memories are fading, oldest first. The curse is doing its work upon me. I am frightened, terribly so. If everything should fade, what will be left of me? I had an older brother. We learned to fence together. He became the most decorated swordsman in all of Myra. I never even compared to him. In fact, I never beat him. Not once. But then, one day, he was gone. Lost without a trace. Now I'm certain that he was taken by the curse. If only someone would hear my tale. My brother must have come here, too. Soon I may forget even about him.
You have proven yourself to the forest. We have little to offer, except perhaps these. May they bring fortune to your journey in some small way.
Shush! You idiot! Stay quiet! I'm on the run. Don't give me away. You're a fugitive too, eh? Yeah? Why else would you be here? It's got death written all over it. You want to climb down here? I can lend you a ladder. But, how much can you offer me? Why, yep. I'm trying to help you, you know. Have you no gratitude? Downright rude, really. I've got a soft heart, so I let you off this once. All right. It'll be just a moment. Ah, go on ahead. I won't offer this deal twice. Psst! Have you heard? Well, apparently, there's this monster lady, right? And the poison, well, does wonders for her body. You know, the health and beauty and that sort of stuff. And I thought only human women were so petty. That creature, she was human once, you know. Yeah. In fact, she was wed to the prince of that nearby castle. But her husband? He had feelings for another. The princess was desperate and sought eternal beauty, hoping that it would restore the prince's affection. You see what I mean? Before long, the princess's ire transformed her into a monster. Now, listen here. When do you think this all happened? Long ago, when this very land was called something else. We say Dranglet now, but countless kingdoms have risen and fallen on this very spot. And this won't be the last. Oh no. That damned hag just can't let her old flame go. She's going to get us all burned. God almighty. I'm not going to die in this dump.
Well, we meet again. There's treasure this way, but I have a bad feeling about it. I don't quite have the guts myself. We went through a lot together. Take this as a token of our friendship. Don't be shy. They were meant for you.
You be careful of him. Pint, I think he said. He wears this rather unusual ring. You know it when you see it. I've seen his type before. He kills entirely for the pleasure of it. I'm sure I won't be his last victim. The man's better off dead. I tell ya. He's a slick talker. So don't let him fool ya.
Well, good to see that you survived. Perhaps you're more rugged than I thought. In any case, the treasure is yours, since you went ahead, took the leap. I prefer a more cautious approach. It's hard to know who to even trust these days. For instance, I've heard that a man is out for my life. Now, what misunderstanding could have ever led to that? The poor bloke must have quite an imagination. You be careful too, my friend, for trust can be a dangerous thing.